Hello and welcome to the 10th part of my LEGO Powered Up tutorial that can also be used for Control Plus and LEGO Boost. Today we will take a look at the layout designer. In the last part we looked at the possibility to change the behavior of given layouts, and today we will look at the layout designer. We don't have to rely on pre-made layouts. We can create our own control layouts. So let's do that. First, we can create a new program. We can enter a name, or we can leave it as it is. Then we can use or select either controller or programming. In my case, both of these have a layout designer. I can either select programming, and then there is a button at the top right corner where I can go to the layout designer, or I can go to controller and select this layout here. That might be patched in the future so that there is only one way, but currently there are both ways. And this is the layout designer. But first let's add the program that we made in the last part, because I will do more or less the same. We had a starting point for the lights. We have the motor control, one for the steering and one for driving. The driving motors were C and D, and the motor to steer is motor A. And for the driving motor, we have to invert the input. And to do that, we have to calculate input times -1 so that positive numbers will get negative, negative numbers will get positive, and that way it will drive forward when the motor drives backwards, and the other way around. So that was the program in the last part. And today we want to make a layout, so we can go to the layout designer. It's this window. Here we can click on the plus, and then we can select a button that we can add. We can add buttons, and there are many buttons. We can select controls, these joysticks, smaller joysticks. I will use one of these sliders to drive the car, one of these sliders to steer the car. I select a red one, but you can select any color you want. And I want to have a output for the current speed, and I want that to be black. Also, I want to add a switch for the light, and that can be done with an off switch. We can either select this one or that one. I think that I will use this one, and it will be yellow for the light. You can move the sliders around, configure them how you want them. Maybe you want to have one point for steering and one point for the extra things. Just make sure that you keep the numbers in mind. In my case, it's 0 to drive, 1 to steer, 2 is our output, the speed output, and 3 is the controller for the lights. Now we can lock this input, and this is the steering interface. Here we can use the buttons and the program runs. So if we would use the buttons in the program, we could interact with the program. But first we have to include the buttons to the program, and they are in this bluish or turquoise category. We have different kinds of buttons for different kinds of inputs. First, we can add the driving mechanism. We can use this input for that. This input block has a number at the bottom that we can select. And that's the number that the button has in the layout designer. So we can go back to the layout designer. Our slider to drive the car is 0. So the number here should be 02. Steering is pretty similar. We can use the same slider, but the number is one for this one because the number in the layout designer is one. Here you can see it. And then we have the output. We can control that with this block. The first number here is the number in the layout designer, and the second number is the actual output. We want to update the value in the output as soon as possible, so we can select a loop. And I suggest that you try to add this on your own. Remember to select the right interface number, but it's not too hard, so think about it on your own. I hope that you did that. We want to output the actual speed, and that can be done with the rotation sensors of the motors. You might not be able to use them if your motors don't have rotation sensors. Then you can use this blocks or these blocks and simply plug them there. Then it would work too, but it wouldn't be as precise. It wouldn't give the actual output value. It would only give the number that the slider has. Again, we want to have the speed of the motors on ports C and D. And we have to invert this one too. Keep in mind that the motors turn the wrong way around, so we have to multiply the actual speed value of the motor with -1. Now the slider would already work, and let's check it out. We can drive. We can steer, and the output resembles the actual speed of the motors. So the program works as we want. I'm not sure if the light works. Sadly, I can't steer and drive at the same time because I'm controlling the device with the mice and I only have one pointer, but I would need two fingers to control this. We don't have the light control yet. So let's get back to the program. Oh, I selected the wrong port. The lights are on port B in my case, and we want to control the light so we don't have to use this number, but we can use an input, and we can simply use the output of our switch. The switch has the ID number 3. And we want to update the light every time so we can put it in a loop. However, this switch doesn't switch between 0 and 100, but between 0 and 1, I think. We can keep the 0 because that would turn the lights off, but we might want to change the output value to a higher one so that the lights are brighter. And we can do that by multiply the 1 with 100. And that way it would shine as bright as possible. So let's try it out. Driving still works, but now we can also use the light. That was it for this part of this tutorial. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you in the next part, and bye.